Portal is a game that doesn't even really need an introduction. It's one of those games that's famous enough that even people who don't follow gaming at all have heard of it. It's so unique that it will probably be influencing other games for years to come, both in terms of mechanics and aesthetics. Dozens of great videos are already out there talking about the design behind test chambers and mechanics of Portal. That's why I'm going to talk about the aesthetic side of it, specifically about something called shape language. Shape language is basically the overall theme of shapes. It's usually used in character design, but it's used for the game as a whole in Portal. It's kind of the primary shape that appears everywhere in the game. In Portal's case, the majority of the shapes are rectangles. Shape language creates a feeling or a general mood for the environment. Rectangles are rigid and restrictive, like boxes or cubicles. That's the feeling Valve is going for when GLaDOS is forcing you to test endlessly. All the test chambers are in rectangular rooms made of rectangular panels in the walls, solving puzzles that use cubes while possibly being watched from a cubicle. Rectangles represent order, but the very name of the game contains something that goes against that. Portals. Portals are rounded. It draws your eye to them for one thing because they stand out from the rectangles in the background. It creates a focal point, which is important because sometimes you need to know where your portal is at a glance. Turrets are also rounded, which are even more important to pick out, especially since they're often the same color as the walls behind them. Circles in Portal are essentially the opposite of rectangles. They feel less rigid and structured than the area around them. Where rectangles are the representation of compliance, circles are almost rebellion. Where rectangles are the building blocks of an evil corporation watching over you, circles are your friend, sometimes literally. It's no coincidence that the companion cube has a shape made entirely of circles on it. Yes, it's just a heart, but think about how much less compelling it would be if it had a more square or jagged shape of some kind on it. Portals and buttons are both helpful to you as things that help you solve test chambers. Circles are just generally a more friendly looking shape. And to some degree, they're a symbol of rebellion in the game. The first half of Portal has tons of rectangles in the background of the test pieces, but that changes after you escape from the normal test chambers. Once you disobey GLaDOS and go outside the confines of the testing area, you immediately start seeing things like tubes, which are circular. You slowly see more and more of this, from pistons to barrels to fans. It peaks at the final fight with GLaDOS, where you literally drop three spheres into a circular furnace. After that, she is sucked into a hole, and outside, the last thing you see is a circular mechanical part fall down. And in the final scene, you see the cake, which is essentially a circle with smaller circles on top of it, with a bunch of spheres in the background. But your hope of getting the cake is extinguished by the evil rectangular robotic fingers. Some of that might be a stretch, but shapes are a very important tool for quickly conveying the general nature of something, without even having to know anything about it. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching this episode of Breakdown.
Thank you for participating in this Aperture Science Computer-Aided Enrichment Activity. Goodbye.